Video 3.5 Over-the-air updates overview. In this video, we will cover the following topics: overview of OTA, need for OTA programming, what is a partition table. Have you ever noticed software updates coming to your mobile phones out of nowhere? You might be thinking now, what is the mode of communication to send software updates? Is someone manually sending these updates to each mobile phone? The answer is no. These updates are nothing but over-the-air updates, abbreviated as OTA. An OTA update travels wirelessly to deliver new softwares, firmware, or other data to devices capable of receiving OTA updates. OTA programming in the world of IoT is the need of time. Over-the-air is a method of transferring data or doing any transaction without making any physical connection. Isn't this idea fascinating? We can send updates wirelessly using OTA functionality if a device is connected to the internet. OTA functionality is very useful in case of no physical access to the device. It reduces the time and effort of updating each device during maintenance. ESP32 comes with OTA functionality. We need to enable OTA on ESP32 boards via ESP-IDF. Let us find out how to enable OTA functionality in the ESP32 board. To understand this, it is important to learn about the partition table in ESP32. A single flash on ESP32 can upload multiple apps along with various kinds of data. Therefore, a partition table is flashed while flashing code on the ESP32 board. To enable OTA functionality, we need to do three app partitions in the partition table: factory, OTA_0, and OTA_1. To do so, enable the factory app to OTA definition option in menu config. The first code that we will flash in the beginning to enable OTA functionality will go in the factory app partition, which will go to the boot loader after flashing. The first code that we will flash will contain OTA functionality and the piece of code that sends the update. After this upload, we can disconnect the board from the system, and now we will do over-the-air update wirelessly. This time, while sending code wirelessly, the code will go to the OTA_0 partition. After an OTA update, the code is sent to the OTA_1 partition and then to the bootloader. When we upload a code wirelessly, we have to remember that our newly uploaded code must have OTA-enabled code and a new update. If the OTA code is not added, our device will lose OTA functionality and we will never be able to send an OTA update to that device. You can also check the version of your software in your code and can update the version if there is an older version on your current device. This means you can send a version update on your device using OTA functionality. We will understand more about sending OTA updates via a simple demonstration in the upcoming lectures of this course. That is all, folks. This brings us to the end of this video. Video summary. In this video, we have covered the following topics: overview of OTA, need for OTA programming, what is a partition table. In the next video, we will see the OTA implementation with ESP-IDF.